Welcome back to my blind playthrough of Red Dead Redemption. I played a little bit off camera. Basically just discovered a new location and played a little blackjack and a little poker. Got a new suit. And did a couple of bounty missions, which is where you find a wanted poster and accept the bounty and then just go on the map where it tells you to go and then kill all the dudes there. You can bring the wanted person back. You can capture them, but you have to have the ability to lasso, and I don't have that yet because I didn't go far enough into the main quest. So today, I'm just going to do a little bit of the main quest, which should be initiated by the letters on the map. And let's see what's closer, the W or the B. I think you get it through Bonnie's missions. And the W's like way farther, so. Night watch job, nice. Anyway, this place I'm at is called Thieves Landing. And it's right here on the map. It's like this little area right here. So I bought a little house right there. Just to have more property and be able to save it somewhere else. And plus this, the saloon over here or whatever has a blackjack table and the other one didn't. Anyway, I'm just waiting on my horse. It's so tempting to just shoot these dudes and take their horses, but I don't do that kind of stuff, man. I'm trying to do everything as honorably as possible in this playthrough. Whoa. My horse is going mad. So we're just riding over to Bonnie McFarlane's place. There's a lot of like side quests you can initiate too. I have like three of them right now. I don't really know what they are, but do them later in the game or something. Who knows? These things keep showing up on the map. I don't know what they are. I'm gonna check that out real quick, actually. Easy. This looks like this is part of one of my side quests. Here we are. Women and cattle.
Mr. Marston, I've been hearing about your plans.
Have you, Miss McFarlane?
Yes, from Lee Johnson, to settle here and build a life for yourself.
I'm afraid those aren't my plans. See, I already have a life. Well, I had one, and I'm trying to reclaim it. Or maybe what you could say is that I had two, and I'm trying to end one of them so the other can survive.
You do so love to talk in riddles, Mr. Marston. Do you do that, I wonder, as a substitute for having anything interesting to say?
Probably, Miss McFarlane.
Oh, call me Bonnie, you fool. Call me Bonnie.
Miss McFarlane, I'm married. I have a son. I had a daughter, but she died. Years before that, I rode in a gang. We robbed banks, trains, held people ransom. We killed people we didn't like. Bill Williamson was in that gang. Now, if I don't capture my former brother in arms, great harm will befall my family. Now, I don't suppose any of this is very interesting to you, but I hope it explains why I wasn't so eager to talk about it.
No, I do understand. I had no idea. You poor man.
Even in this new country, memories don't really fade. My father was an illiterate Scot born on the boat into New York. He never saw his homeland, but to hear him talk about it, you'd imagine he only ever ate haggis and wore a kilt. And he hated the English for what they had done to his great-grandparents that he'd never met. People don't forget. Nothing gets forgiven.
That's true, especially when it comes to money. And you know, even now, after all his labors, my father's debts are still terrible. I worry every day about us losing the ranch. It would kill him.
My father died when I was 8 years old. His eyes were, well, let's just say he was blinded in a bar fight south of Chicago. My mother died during childbirth. She was a prostitute, and he was her, well, I don't know what he was. So I was sent off to an orphanage and ran away and fell in with a gang.
My word. What a difficult life you've lived.
The leader of the gang taught me how to read, taught me how to see all that was good in the world. He was a great man in a way.
But you killed people.
Sure. And I've suffered for it. And that's the life I left, or tried to leave. Said too much, Bonnie. I'm an uneducated killer, sent here to do all I can do well. Kill a man in cold blood so that another man may do his part to cut crime in an area, and a rich man can be elected governor on the back of these promises.
Civilization is a truly beautiful thing, Mr. Marston. Listen, can you help me?
Well, I can try. What do you need, money?
No, nothing so complicated. I need an extra hand to take out the herd to pasture.
Sure. Point me in the right direction.
Are you ready to learn how to herd some cows? Whoa! Thank you for telling me all that back there. It must have been hard for you.
Hope you understand now why I've been playing my cards somewhat close to my chest.
I didn't know you had a wife and child. Then again, I don't think I ever asked. They're lucky to have a man like you.
I ain't so sure about that, but thank you.
Good to see you, Miss McFarlane.
Easy now.
Yeah.
That's it. Nice
job, Mr. Marston.
Drive them down the road, Mr. Marston. Gee up.
I see.
Look at the cowboy.
Come on, you dumb
heifer.
Ain't that hard, is it?
Let's go.
This way. We need to take them out to the pasture.
Yeah, there you go.
Come on.
Your Let's go.
True calling, Mr. Marston. Either that, or you were a cow in a past life.
Thank you, Miss McFarland.
I'll see you later. I have work to do back at the ranch.
$5 for that, man? That's nothing.
Come on.
Jobs and towns pay twice as much. See, it pays to be a good guy, man. Of course, if I do a second playthrough, I'm gonna just kill everybody. I don't know how far you can get though, playing like that though, but. Anyway, let's go ahead and see if we can get another mission out of her real quick. Yeah, it looks like this one's gonna be the lasso. The thing where I can learn the lasso so I can start capturing the criminals instead of killing them.
Fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Did you meet my father? John Marston, this is my father, Drew McFarland.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Marston. Please. So, my daughter informs me that you're here on some secret mission to remove some undesirables from the county.
Something like that. I'm grateful for the hospitality, sir.
Well, you know, we've lived here for 30 years now. Came here from the east. The land had never been settled. For 10 years, we fought the Indians. Tough men. And we had outlaws, and we had drought, and we had smallpox, terrible winters, cholera. I buried more of my children than I raised.
Sorry to hear that, sir.
I've seen strong men wither and die under that unforgiving sun. That whole herd of cattle take sick and die. But I've never once doubted my life here.
No, sir.
When I hear about this so-called federal government sending out agents to covertly murder and control people, then I start to worry. I mean, yeah, all right, Williamson is a menace, and men like him are the plague. But isn't a government agent a worse menace? And all that symbolizes, I mean.
You may be right, sir.
Well, you're a brave man. You're always going to be welcome here. But you tell your friends out east that we don't want to live like that out here. And sneaking around and spying and secret missions. It's preposterous.
Trust me, sir. I agree with you.
Good. Well, we won't insult you any further. Come on, Bonnie, we got things to do.
Mr. Marston, do you want to join us? It's Daddy's favorite pastime, apart from political discourse, that is.
What is?
Breaking in horses. Come on, I hear you're a pretty decent rider. For a city dweller, that is.
You're gonna need this, Mr. Marston. Right, now you got some rope on your belt. Let's see if we can't wrangle some horses.
Cool. I don't think this was my horse, but that's okay, I guess.
You sure have some interesting theories on what the government's doing, sir.
They ain't theories, Mr. Marston. I saw the telegram Marshall got from Blackwater. It ain't exactly a state secret that sent you.
Well, is he wrong? I saw those men from the train.
The government can go to hell if you ask me. Those sons of bitches would steal a coin off a dead man's eye.
Mr. Marston!
He's right. Now, I don't know much about politics.
Please, Paul, can we just enjoy
the
ride?
But I know we're only as free as they say we are. Power's like a drink. The more you have, the more you want. And there are few men who can handle it.
There's certain things in this country a woman could do much better, if you ask me.
I ain't gonna argue with that, Miss McFarland.
I didn't even realize they were following me there. What the fuck? So because they decided to get on their horse and start, like, flying away from me, I lost?
Come on, Mr. Marston.
That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
Oh, I think because the horse they wanted me to lasso was just part of the big herd at the beginning. And since I, the one horse ran off and I went after that one instead, it failed me. It's stupid though. I did the mission. It's like, it's not like it mattered. Anyway. Looks like now we can lasso.
Somewhere outside of Armadillo.
Let's go, Mr. Marston. We can really do with those horses. No rest for the wicked. Let's see if we can track down that other herd of horses.
You never did tell me why you were never married. Aside from the snobbery, that is.
You sure ask a lot.
I'm just surprised, that's all. You must have been quite a catch. That's not what I mean. You must have had some suitors, that's all I'm saying.
Some, I suppose. Here and there. A ranch in the middle of Hennigan's stead ain't really the place to find a husband. Amos, he's a little, well, you know, countrified.
Where'd you get your airs and graces, Miss McFarland?
From a couple of cheap governesses Pa hired to save us from being savages. I'd like to talk about more than just cattle and chickens sometimes, that's all. And after my brother left, it was up to me to become the man of the ranch. He'd never admit it, but my pa's a lot frailer than he looks.
You're worth two of any man I know, miss.
I'll try to take that as a compliment.
In many ways, my wife is kind of like you, Miss McFarland.
Is that so?
She's always been a woman in a man's world.
You don't talk about her very much. Looks like the ranch hand's up ahead.
See you there, miss. Whoa there. Let's go. Slow it up now.
Oh no, I'm like losing them all. Where the hell is everybody else that's supposed to be helping with this? Okay, I can't get all these fucking horses by myself, guys. Like, I don't understand.
Come on, easy up now.
go. Dude, I pressed fucking triangle, it just didn't work. Here we go. It's bullshit, man. Seriously, it's fucking stupid. Right in front of him, I ran up in a triangle and it didn't fucking register. Oh, you have to keep holding L2. How nice of them not to tell me that. Oh, that's great. Back on him, idiot. You think they could give me a camera angle where I could actually see what's happening? Little glitchy right there.
Thanks for your help today, Mr. Marston. We got some fine horses. You know, why don't you keep that stallion as your own, as a thank you from all of us?
Thank you, ma'am. He's a fine animal.
Those honor points. Let's see, where am I? Vacant property, huh? I'm actually gonna go ahead, head back towards Bonnie's. And see what's up with this night watch job. And it's a good thing this game has awesome graphics with all the riding around you have to do. New items to purchase from the store, sweet. And finally back at the ranch. Looks like it's gonna storm or something, maybe. I played poker with this guy before. Oh, that's cool. Never knew about that. Is this night watchman thing? American appetite, order and honesty. Let me think about this. 100 alive, 80 dead. Man, I just wanted to see what was up with that night watchman job for the end of this video. How much money do I have? 84 still. Let's see what new is available at the store here. Survival map. Show all nearby herbs for 20 minutes. Not available. Sickly looking dark brown horse. Slow speed. Nobody has fast speed yet. It's always funny bumping into the people in these Rockstar games.
Dear sir, hello. Hi there. Hello there. Howdy, friend.
Yeah, the game just really wants me to do the wanted thing, but I'm gonna do that in the next part of my videos. You can join in on Games of Horseshoes. Oh, cool.
Well, hello.
Guess we could try one of those real quick. It's probably going to end in failure because I don't know what I'm doing.
How good is you at throwing horseshoes?
Tossing horseshoes controlled by the point of release. You can send a horseshoe farther back by choosing a lower release point.
Not bad.
You can fine-tune the distance by pulling your arm back less. Practice tossing. It's also where you push R up and down. You can aim left and right. Use L2 to aim and line up your shot. Anyway, yeah, I suck at fuck horseshoes. Yeah, he got my $6. Whatever. I can always win it back off camera playing poker or blackjack anyway. So anyway, that's part 3 of my blind playthrough of Red Dead Redemption on a PlayStation 3. Change back to my regular clothes and save it. So thanks for watching.